Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
Aww.
Good morning.
That was cute.
Hallelujah.
Say it like we're excited.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
We are so grateful for God's new mercies that he has bestowed upon us this brand new day. Amen. We're going to sing a song that I know a lot of you love. It's talking about overflow. As God has blessed us, we want to not be greedy with the blessings. We want it to overflow to others, okay? So I want for you to stand up on your feet if you want to, if you want to. And we're going to praise and bless the name of our God. Hallelujah. Put your hands together like so. All right.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Good morning, Antioch. Good morning, Antioch.
Good morning.
Hallelujah. For this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Hallelujah. If God has been good to you this past week, give him a hand clap of praise. Amen. For we serve an awesome God. We serve a mighty God. Amen. And he is worthy of all of our praise, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, Father God, we come before you this morning, Father God, on this wonderful and beautiful day, Father God. Father God, just ready, Father God, and able and willing, Father God, this morning, just to give you all the honor, to give you all the glory, and give you all the praise. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you this morning for your presence. We thank you, Father God, for your anointing, even that of your Holy Spirit this morning, Father God. Father God, we continue to welcome your presence, your anointing, even that of your Holy Spirit this day, Father God, upon us, around us, and with us this morning, Father God. Father God, as we lift up and praise and worship that of your holy and mighty name, Father God, we even come before you this morning, Father God, just asking you continue to look down upon our pastor and his family and their absences, Father God. Father God, we pray that you would continue to just keep that of your loving arms, even that of your guardian angels around and them with them, Father God, and that you would bring him back into us safe and sound, Father God. And Father God, we also just pray and lift up Pastor Thomas this morning, Father God, as he has prepared, Father God, this morning, Father God, to bring forth yet of your word, Father God, of life, help, strength, and encouraging unto us, Father God, as we continue, Father God, to run this tedious journey that you have set us upon this morning. So, Father God, as we come before you, Father God, through songs, through prayer, Father God, and even as we listen to your word, we pray, Father God, for your presence, that of your anointing, even that of your Holy Spirit this morning, Father God, to be into this place. So, Father God, we thank you this morning. We bless you out of your holy, mighty name. We pray and ask all these things this day and every day, Father God, in that of your darling Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen, amen, amen.
In that same theme of flow, we want all of our praise and our worship to flow to our King of Kings. Yes, we are here, and sometimes it becomes a routine. We just come because that's what we do on Sunday mornings. But I want for you to focus your attention on the purpose of your presence, and it's to give God all the praise, the honor, and the glory. Hallelujah. Flow to you. Let the river of my worship flow to you, Lord, I pray, in all I do. Let the river of my worship flow to you, like streams in the valley. They swell with the rain. Let the songs of my heart, let them rise to bless your name and flow to you. Flow to you. Lord, let my worship.
Flow to you.
Let the river of my
Let all my worship,
all my praise,
let all my praise go to you.
Go to you.
Go to you.
And let all my worship,
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 let all my worship.
Y'all already know. Get your hands up. Come on. We're going to praise the Lord this morning. Huh? Amen. Come on. How many of y'all know God is your everything? If he's your everything, stand up and let him know that he's your everything. Okay, here we go.
He's my rock.
Oh, yeah.
Well, he's my rock.
He's my rock. Oh, in yeah. A weary
land. I still tell him.
In the time of war.
Somebody say, God is.
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 He's the present help.
God is.
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 He's my joy.
Good morning, everyone. Please stand for the responsive reading. I will read the leader, you the congregation. Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. All, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Today's hymn is number 102, He Lives.
Thank you.
to Pastor Jones, First Lady Jones, ministers, Antioch family, friends, and those watching us online, good morning. Thank you for joining us today. We are happy and honored you chose to worship with us. Last call to register and join another exciting couples ministry gathering this Saturday, August 24th from 4 to 6 p.m. We will have an invaluable workshop by Deacon Ken Battles of Compass Urban on money and marriage. Please register on the church app and online, confirming your attendance to access Meal Train to volunteer a dish for our potluck. Please notify us immediately if childcare is required. We look forward to seeing you. The Boys and Girls Club registration is open for the school year. The cost is $30 for 12 and under and free for kids 13 and older. Must be at least 6 years old to join. Please help the mission ministry as we go out for our third quarter service day on September 14th, 2024. We will be in Sanford ministering to the homeless in three different areas. How can you help? Fill a small backpack or string bag, bright colors for women and dark colors for men, with toiletries usable by a homeless person. Include canned meat that does not require can openers, such as Vienna sausages, sardines, spams, lunch meat, and etc. You can go with us also. Deadline is September 1st. Any questions? Contact Minister Lovely Beeman at 407-715-5075 or Minister Tara at 407-718-1884. Come join us on one of our small group Sunday school classes next Sunday at 9 a.m. Join us this Wednesday for Family Enrichment Night here in the sanctuary and on Zoom. Head to our website for the link to join on Zoom if you cannot make it in person. As always, we ask that you keep our sick, shut-in, and bereaved families in your thoughts and prayers. Is there anyone who has celebrated a birthday since last Sunday? Happy birthday. How about any anniversaries? Congratulations. Do not forget to like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at AMBC Oviedo. Our app is available to download in your app store. Search Antioch MBC Oviedo. Additional announcements and upcoming ministry activities can be found in the church app and on our website. Remember to check on a regular basis. Please be courteous to our parking attendants and follow their directions. We remind you to only cross the street where police are present and be aware of new traffic patterns. Antioch Church family, thank you all for so much for the cards, calls, and visits. I greatly appreciate the love and thoughtfulness and prayers. I love you all. Mama Sue. Will any visitors please stand? The ladies of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated and the brothers of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated. We are excited and grateful that you have come to be with us this morning. It is our hope that you experience the love of Christ and his presence during our worship. God loves you and we do too. Please remain standing so that our ushers can give you a visitor's card. Have a great day and a blessed week.
Now, you know y'all giving me the mic today. Sister LaShawn, Miss Royal. Good morning, Antioch. I'm going to wait for the president of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated to get up here with me. First of all, I would just like to say thank you guys for welcoming the sisters of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated and the brothers of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated as we celebrated our Blue and White weekend. We have been Family Day Friday, Cookout Saturday, and we need to worship together on Sunday. So we haven't been here to this church, and there's a lot of Sigmas go to this church. And I said, we need to come to my church. And it's a lot of us. So first of all, with all the ladies of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, please stand.
Every time without fail, if he's on the mic, I have to be on the mic too. So good morning, Antioch. On behalf of the Epsilon Epsilon Zeta chapter that serves Orlando and Osceola County, we are just so appreciative of allowing us to be in this house of worship this morning. We thank you for just allowing us to be together in fellowship amongst our brothers and sisters in Christ. So thank you so much for having us this morning.
Thank you, ladies. Now, can the brothers of Phi Beta Sigma Fraternity Incorporated please stand? See, I told y'all we deep up in here. So we just want to thank you guys and bring a small token of appreciation. I'll take this, since you know I'm on the trustee board, I'll take this right on back to the finance, to the finance room. And we thank you guys for having us.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, God is awesome, and we're glad today that we have a baby dedication. Amen. And we know that children come from the Lord, and it is an awesome thing whenever what God gives to us, we offer back to Him. And so that's what we're doing today. So if the parents, Dion Simon and Ricardo Simon, bring their baby up, Lana Simon. And you guys can stand right here in front of me. It's facing me. All right. So I'm going to read a few words, and then I'll ask you to affirm in a little bit that you will train Lana up to know the Lord. And then we're going to anoint Lana, and we're going to pray for you all and let you guys know that we're here for you today and the days going forward. Amen. The scripture says, they brought young children to Christ that he should touch them, and his disciples were rebuked those that brought them. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, suffer the little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. Verily I say unto you, whoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And he took them up into his arms and put his hands on them, and he blessed them. At this time, I'm gonna go ahead and ask you to anoint Lana. Amen. Dearly beloved, the divine human task of developing child after birth is the most delicate and serious work which man is called. All the sights and sounds that play upon the sensitive little body help to determine the future characteristics of the child. The love of the home and the affections given towards the child from the parents affect the child in a thousand ways for good. As the child grows, it may receive spiritual life from parents. And so it's important for you as parents to keep your lives open to God so that the same life and blessing that God gives to you, the same direction that God gives to you, you can also give to your child. If it's your duty, therefore, to receive this child as it is from the hand of God and teach her to know and to love God and working in obedience to God's will to help the unfolding of Lana's spiritual life. From your example, Lana must learn to pray. From your example, she must learn to read and love the Bible. And from your example, she must learn the way of fellowship with Christ. So, Mr. and Mrs. Simon, do you promise to do the best you can to train Lana and to, at the proper time, to lead her into a relationship with Christ?
Yes.
Amen. So we're going to go ahead and pray for you now. Do we have anybody that came with this family today? Anybody who came, you can come and stand as we pray for them in support of them. Right. And how do I pronounce her name? Lana. Let's go ahead and pray. God, we thank you for this beautiful gift of Lana. And we know, God, that Lana came from you. As the Bible says, that children are a heritage of the Lord. We thank you, Lord God, for depositing Lana into the loins, Lord God, of this family, Dion and Ricardo. And just pray, God, that you continue to lead them, Lord, as parents, that they may help Lana, Lord God, to develop over the years into the young lady that you have already purposed for her to be. So we pray, God, your blessings upon Lana. We pray, God, your blessings upon this family, and that you would keep them, Lord God, all the days of their life. We thank you, God, and we give you praise, and we bless you for this. In Jesus' name, amen. Go ahead and turn to the congregation and announce your baby's name, first and last, loud and clear.
This is Lana Janae Simon.
Amen. Amen. And so to remember this day, we're happy to play a part in dedicating Lana to the Lord. And to remember this day, family, we want to give you this certificate. It's a certificate of baby dedication. We hereby commit to raising this child, Lana Simon, in the nurture and admonition of the Lord on this 18th day of August in the year of our Lord, 2024, at Antioch Missionary Baptist Church. And so we want to present this to you and thank you for allowing us to dedicate your baby today. God bless you and keep you as our prayer. You may take your seats.
Antioch, it's offering time. The offering trays will be passed around to receive your tithes and offerings. There are also many other ways to give. You can give online at www.antioch-mbc.org, as well as through our AMBC Oviedo Church app. You can also mail your gift to the church at 311 East Broadway Street, Oviedo, Florida, 32765, or place in the drop box located in the back of the church. Okay, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us all here today. I pray that you will bless everyone who has given and those who wish they could give but couldn't. Let these offerings be used to better your kingdom. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Thank you.
belongs to you. Yeah, my hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, 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 my hallelujah belongs to you. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Wonderful. Amen. If you believe he's wonderful, why don't you stand to your feet and give him a praise today? Hallelujah. He is the King of Kings. Amen. He is the Lord of Lords and King of Kings. Hallelujah. He is worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. He is wonderful. Jesus is to me. Amen. Is that your testimony today, that Jesus is wonderful? Amen. And give it up for this wonderful choir. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. We thank God. We are blessed to have such a wonderful choir that can be in sync and do all that. I was sitting there like, man, I'd be messing that up so bad right now. But praise God, they are in their lane and walking in their anointing and ushering us into the presence of worship. God bless you. Thank you. Amen. We're about to hear from heaven. Amen. And we're going to be going again. If you were here last week, amen, we were in Isaiah 43. And we're going to be there again this week as we pick up again from our Pastor Thomas on Breakthrough. Amen. So we have Isaiah 43, verses 16 through 19. Amen. And starting from the 16th verse, it reads, "Thus saith the Lord, which maketh a way in the sea, and a path in the mighty waters, which bringeth forth the chariot and horse, the army and the power. They shall lie down together, they shall not rise, they are extinct, they are quenched as tow. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his already blessed word. Preach, Pastor Thomas.
Clap of praise. Come on and lift your hands to the Lord. Lord, we thank you today and we worship you today. God, we are open to you, Lord God, and we are available to you. Lord, it is you, God, who has made us and not we ourselves. We are your people and the sheep of your pasture. So we pray now, God, speak to us because we are attentive, Lord, and we are listening. We thank you, God, that as you speak to us today, God, that your word will be planted in our hearts and that this moment will push us forward into the things that you have planned for us. We thank you, Lord, and we welcome your presence. And just ask you to have your way, God, because as for your way, it is perfect. We love you We worship you, and we are waiting on you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, and we bless you. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. We thank God just for being God. Amen. God is a great God, and we sing glory, hallelujah. We give honor to Pastor Jones on today in his absence. Come on and give Pastor Jones a hand for the his love for God and just continuing to seek after God. So we thank God for him, and we thank God for everyone in their respective places. I thank God for everybody who is joining us online. Thank you for visiting us again, and we thank you again as well for all of our visitors that are here in the sanctuary again. And God bless little Lana as well, amen, and her family for being here, dedicating the baby back to the Lord, amen. And so we have prayed, and we're going to continue to talk today by the Spirit of God and by the help of the Lord about breakthrough, amen. And last week, as we looked at the scripture in Isaiah that Pastor read, we seen that God wants us to forget some things that maybe have happened in our past, or forget some things that didn't go our way in the past, because everything in your past does not dictate the things that God is going to do for you in the future. Amen. And so the breakthrough that happens on the outside, or the breakthrough that happens within our lives as we walk day to day through difficult times that demand a divine intervention from God, right? Those breakthroughs that will happen in our lives, on our jobs, in our relationships, those breakthroughs, they first begin within us, right? The breakthrough that's going to be manifested in our daily walk, that breakthrough must first begin within us and within our mind, and in the way that we think, and in the way that we believe and know what God will do within ourselves. And so that's why we spent some time on last week looking at ourselves and saying, hey, let's forget about some of the things that we have been through in the past. Let's forget about some of the failures. Let's forget about all of those past things, because we have to let those things go in order to get a breakthrough into the places that God would take us. Amen? And so we spent a lot of time in that area. We spent a lot of time on last week also talking about failures, and on how failures within ourselves and failure within our life and us not doing everything that we're supposed to do, we talked about that does not exclude us from future breakthrough or for God doing something new in our life right now. Amen? Because all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Amen? And so we learned to let that go. And we looked at Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11, which says that God has a future and a hope for our lives. Despite the things that we didn't do right, despite all of the wrong that we've done, God still has a purpose and a plan for our life. Amen? And as I was thinking, I thought back to last week. I want us to be encouraged that God has a greater plan for our life than we do. And I always say, in order for us to be who God made us to be, we have to stay connected to the Creator, right? How can we be who God made us to be if we're not connected to God? Now, we can be a lot of things, and we can do a lot of things, amen? But in order for us to really be who God created us to be, we have to be connected to God. And a lot of times what God tells us and who God tells us that we are doesn't match up with how we feel on the inside. Sometimes we feel like the thing that God is calling us to or what he's telling us to do is far above and beyond what we really think about ourselves. And we talked about Jeremiah on last week, how God told him that he knew him before he was in his mother's womb. And so God will speak to you and God will share with you. But before we begin to move in the direction and be who God created us to be, we must first maintain, hallelujah, that relationship with God. Hallelujah. Somebody lift your hands to the Lord and say, Lord, help me be who you created me to be. Amen. And so in order to be who God created us to be, and in order to get those breakthroughs, it's going to have to first come within us with God sharing some things for us and for us still believing what God says about who? About us. Because sometimes God is telling us that we're somebody that other people have not told us that we are. And we have we think about ourselves sometimes in a negative way, right? But God is saying something different. Amen. As we look at these slides and move forward, I wanted to bring us up. But many times, if we look at this slide here about traumatized, being traumatized, tired, and trained by misfortune, they're going to pull that slide up. We talked also last week about how the children of Israel had been back and forth, not even counting the time that they came out of Egypt, which we talked a little bit about last week. They were in exile and in bondage at least four times within the history of this nation. This nation has a history of following God and then not following God and going back into bondage, then God bringing them out of bondage, then they go back and do what they want to do again. So they have this cycle, right, within Israel of falling down at some point in their walk. Amen? And so just like our life, sometimes we're traumatized, right, by things that happen within our life. And those things seem to stick with us because it's something. And sometimes we just get in a particular place where we're just so tired and we're just so stagnated in a place that we can't even hear what God is really saying. We're desensitized to the word of hope and the word that God could do something new because we're so traumatized by what we've been through. We're so stagnated, right, by just our day-to-day life. So if somebody came and told us that God is going to go before us and do something new in our life because we've been stuck in places so long, we don't even believe, right, that God is going to do something new. We are so trained by the misfortunes till we just get stuck and say that this is the place for me, not knowing that right there in the place where you are. Thank God. Somebody lift your hand and say, thank God I'm still alive. Yeah, you've been through a lot. You've been traumatized, praise God. You've had misfortune after misfortune, and you said, God, why me, praise God? And it don't seem like it's going to change, but you got to remember the word of the Lord. It says, grow not weary in well-doing. Grow not weary in well-doing, because you will reap if you faint not, praise God. And that is something, see, sometimes the breakthroughs that happen in our life don't happen in one moment. It's a succession and a continuation of us continuing to not give up. It's a multitude of small breakthroughs that bring us to the larger breakthroughs, to where we're at a place now that we've been waiting for all our lives. Don't you know people who are CEOs of companies, most of the time they didn't just come to be the CEO. They started at a place, and sometimes because we graduate from college, we can't just think that because we graduate from college and we have a PhD that we're going to get the corner office all the time. Sometime your breakthrough, praise God, is going to take some work. It's going to take some pressing. It's going to take some don't stop. It's going to take some don't quit. It's going to take some hanging in there when it don't seem like it's no reason to hang in there. And your breakthrough, your larger breakthrough can be a multitude of several breakthroughs. Tell somebody don't quit. Micah 2:13 is where we began to look at. Micah 2:13 is where we looked at, and this scripture comes to the children of Israel yet again. And this minor prophet, not because he was smaller than any of the other prophets, but just because of the time and the length of his prophecies, you'll see that his prophecy, his book, is not as large as Isaiah, Ezekiel, so in the time that he ministered. So it's not because his anointing was any less than Jeremiah's or Isaiah's, but he is called one of the minor prophets. And this minor prophet, Micah, is speaking to these children of who? Israel, who tend to have these problems with going back and forth. And he's speaking to them, trying to tell them. And actually, in the book of Micah, the leaders of Israel was having problems by using their power to distort and to steal from people who didn't have as much power. So they were doing things, actually going to sleep at night, thinking about how they're going to get the little man. How they gonna take? How they gonna use their power to make them more rich and not worrying about all of the people? They was just worrying about themselves. Amen. And so Micah is preaching to this nation. He's telling them, "You need to stop. The leaders, you guys need to stop being unfair. You need to stop being ungodly. You need to stop worshiping these idols, because if you don't, there is gonna be a payment that you have to pay for your sin." But in the midst of this, in the midst of the people, the leaders being, hallelujah, unfair and unjust, God still had a problem and a promise in the midst of the problems. I remember one time, and we're going to stick with this. I remember one time, one of the most traumatic times of my life, I was sitting there, and God gave me this scripture. I believe it's in Corinthians 10:13. God will not put more on you in your bed than you can bear. How did the scripture go? God will not allow you to be tempted above that you're able, right? But with the very temptation, right there at the same time. Like right in the same time that you're going through, right in the time when you're in a pickle, right in the time when your back is against the wall, you need to be looking and listening and praying to God. God, I don't know how I got here. It don't look like I can get out, God, but I'm calling you, praise God, to help me to get out of this. God, hallelujah, right with the temptation, he will make a way of escape, a way that you'll be able to get through. And on that morning, when I was going through that, I didn't see today. That was probably 11 or 12 years ago. I did not see today, but thank God that I'm here. And when God spoke to me, that it didn't take away all the reality of the trauma and the pain that I was going through. No, it didn't take away all of the pain. It didn't take away the reality. But I had a word from God in the midst of my troubles telling me that I'm going to give you a way of escape and you're going to be able to bear this. And he also let me know that there's a lot of other people in the world that have problems other than you. So what are you sitting here feeling sorry for yourself for? Micah chapter 2, verse 13, this prophet, he's telling them in the midst of their problem, he's saying the breaker is going to come up before them. They have broken up and they have passed through the gate and are gone by it, and their king shall pass before them, and the Lord on the head of them. Praise God. And when you want to get through anything that's too hard for you, yeah, things that are impossible for man are possible with God. You might find yourself in a place where you've been for a long time. You might find yourself in a place where you just don't think you can get through. But things that are impossible for me, praise God, things that are impossible for you, praise God, you got somebody that can break through the doubts of your mind, first of all, that's trying to speak to and tell you that you're going to make it, trying to speak to you and tell you that you are above, praise God, and not beneath, praise God. But you have somebody that's greater that can break through any army and anything that stands before you, praise God. He is the breaker, praise God. I know you've heard, praise God, of God, praise God, Jehovah Nisi, praise God. He's our banner, praise God. I know you probably heard of Jehovah, he provides, praise God. He's our provider, praise God. You might have heard, praise God, of the Alpha, praise God, and the Omega, praise God, the beginning and the end. You might have heard of Jesus being the bread of life, praise God. You might have heard of Jesus being the morning star, praise God. You might have heard of him saying that I am that I am. But in this particular scripture, we see another name of God, and it's called, he is called in this scripture, the breaker. He is the one that can break through where it seems like there is no breakthrough. He's the one that's greater than anything that stands before you in any calamity or anything, any trauma in your mind. He can even renew your mind so you can even see things. Praise God. He's the one that can break things on the inside of you, in your spirit, in your soul, and in your body. He's the one that can break down walls that are impeding or that are stopping you from going where he has purpose and plan. In this particular scripture, we find God is the breaker. And don't be dismayed by the challenges that you're going through, because this is the time that you need the breaker most to act on your behalf. Amen. I want to share with you a scripture, because now we want to see how we allow God or the breaker to go forth and break up things in our life that we can't seem to get past. Amen? Let's look at 2 Samuel, 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 19, verse 20. Now, I want to give you something. I want to give you something. I want to give you a word of hope. I want to give you a word of encouragement. And we started out within this. I ask you to raise your hands and say, God, I am who you say that I am. God has a purpose and God has a plan for you. And just because it may be delayed, the promises that God has promised you, you know God. You know who you are, and people won't even let you operate in who you are sometimes. You know you got it, but they won't give you your chance to show that you got it. But it's in you, amen? But sometimes you got to hold on to who you are in dark spaces and tight places, praise God, and just wait for God to give you, praise God, hallelujah, the place, praise God. Jesus was always Jesus, but he came forth at the appointed time. He always been the Son of God from, praise God, from before the earth was born. He was always the Son of God, but it was at the appointed time that Jesus came to the earth. And some of us, we're going to have to take some of the time sitting in the back, praise God, when you know you have the answer and nobody won't ask you. Some, you're going to have to sit back and just
be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding, praise God, in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain, you're going to have to learn how to sit back and keep waiting for your time. Keep waiting, because God has a time. He has a season. He has a set time. And your time may not be the same time as God's time. So therefore, you got to wait for the breaker to set things up for you, to make a way for you. And then he says, now walk through. Tell some sis, listen, keep waiting. Tell somebody to keep waiting. You keep trusting. You keep knowing. You keep growing within you. You keep developing your gift. You keep sharpening up your sword. Don't you give up now. You take that time to develop. Don't take that time to sow. Take that time when you're on the backside, praise God, of the desert, to keep honing your gift. So when you do get the call, when you do get an opportunity to stand up, you'll be able to go forth. In this particular scripture, 2 Samuel chapter 19, verses 19 and 20, right? Chapter 5, right? It's right up there. We had this love-hate relationship. But listen, in the beginning of this, we won't go back to there, but 2 Samuel chapter 5, do you know what happens? David, who was anointed to be king by Samuel, had to run from the person who the people had made king. For all these years, he has this anointing on his life to be the king, and he trying to stay out of confrontation with the one that the people had made king, which was Saul. All these years, he go through this and that, and he is anointed. He got it in him. He got the very anointing of God on him to be who God called him to be. At a young age, he was called. At a young age, he was anointed. Amen? It didn't come until this particular chapter that we're reading, 2 Samuel chapter 5, you'll see that all of the elders of Israel, praise God, came to David. All of them now, they came to David after the kings that they put up didn't seem to stand up because they weren't anointed by God. And you know how it is in our life, when everything else don't work, we try everything else we can. And after everything else we try don't work, then all of a sudden we want to come to God. But thank God that God's still there. Somebody lift your hands and say, God, I thank you that you're still there. I tried a whole bunch of stuff. I did a whole bunch of things. I did it my way. But God, I thank you that by time I really get it together and realize that them people are not who they say they are, when I don't know as much as I think I know, God, I'm glad that you are still there. And so these people of Israel, they finally, after the other kings that worked at Hebron, they was the coronation of David as the king of the whole nation of Israel. It didn't happen when he was anointed to do it. He had to go through at least 15 years of running and chasing and defeats and failures. He had to go through those whole fields. I'm telling you, don't give up. I'm telling you, I hope that your failures and the place where you didn't get it together, I pray for you and I pray for me that our failures was just training for our ultimate breakthrough and being who God has ultimately called us to be. Second Samuel chapter 5, verse 19 and 20. Y'all know David done some stuff that went right. Right? Now, y'all might not know everything that Jermaine did that wasn't right, but Jermaine done some stuff that wasn't right. And whatever, that's your business, you know what I mean? I'm the one preaching, so I got to keep it going. And so 2 Samuel chapter 5, this is how we get breakthrough in our life. 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 19 through 20. So let's read it together. So David inquired of the Lord. Shall I go and attack the Philistines or Philistines? Will you deliver them into my hands? The Lord answered him, go, for I will surely deliver the Philistines into your hands. So David went to Baal-perazim, and there he defeated them. Amen. And so one of the things that we have to learn to do if we're going to get breakthrough in our life, because remember, in Micah chapter 2, verse 13, let's read this. Let's consider it, and it's up there on the screen. The breaker came up, what, behind them? No, you got to allow the one that's stronger. You got to allow God. Somehow you got to position yourself behind the one and with the one that can do anything. You got to submit. You got to, the Bible says in the New Testament, resist, praise God, the devil, praise God, submit to God and resist the devil, right? So you got to get yourself in a place to where you behind and you with the one who breaking up stuff in front of you. Not running wherever you want to go and say, now, God, come do this. Come, God, come take care of that for me. Running all over here, so, God, come take care of this for me. Oh, I done made this mess over here. God, come take care of this for me. Now, he will do that, won't he? Everybody, I'm a testimony. God will come and help you sometime when you done got out of the way, right? But that's not really the way how we want to experience breakthrough in our life. The way we want to experience breakthrough in our life is ask God for direction. And ask him, God, do you want me to go this way? And then he'll say, yes, I want you to go that way, and I'm going to go before you, and I'm going to give you the victory. This is not going to be a victory that you could have got on your own. Don't think that everything that you got, don't think that Jermaine is standing here because of something on his own. Jermaine had other plans for his life, praise God. And even the plans, I'm just so thankful for God because it's God in my life. And as I was preparing for this, I'm so thankful that God has plans for my life that I don't even understand, praise God. But I'm just waiting for it all to unfold. It's been beautiful this far because I'm standing here only by the grace of God. And praise God. So it's awesome this far. And I look back at my life and see what all the destruction and all the mistakes and all the things. I'm glad that God brought me through all of that to get me to right here. And I don't believe, praise God, that he brought me this far to lead me, praise God. I believe that he who has begun this good work in me, I believe he's going to keep working in me as long as I keep myself available. As long as I keep standing before him, I believe it's another breakthrough right around the corner. I believe it's another breakthrough right down there in that valley. Yeah, I may have to go through some valleys, praise God. I might have to experience some hardships, but I know that in the midst of those hardships, and in the midst of those challenges, there is a breaker that can help me break through these challenges. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I don't have to fear no evil because the breaker is. I'm coming out of this. Yeah, I'm in the middle of it, but I'm coming out. I'm not here to stay. I'm just walking through. I'm just visiting. I'm just saying hello. I'm just here to bless somebody in the valley while I'm on my way up to the mountaintop. Look at this next one. This next slide, it says, so he called it Baal-perazim, which he had a name for that place now because remember, he asked God, right? Should I go forth or should I not? And he called that place where God gave him the victory over the Philistines, he called that place Baal-perazim, the owner of breakthroughs. Or the Lord of breakthroughs. If you want the Lord of the owner of breakthroughs, he's the one. He is God, is the owner. God, he's not only Alpha and Omega, he's the Lord of breakthrough. And if you got yourself in a tight spot, if you find yourself in a tight spot, we need to practice 1 Samuel chapter 5, verses 19 through 20, and ask God, what should I do? And if God don't say nothing, don't do what he, and don't do nothing different than what he told you before. I always say continue to worship where you are. You want to be somewhere else, but you're not nowhere else right now. You right here, and this is the last place that God told you to be. You don't know nowhere else to go, because this is the last place that God dropped you off and say, wait here and stop here. And so wherever you are, you might want to be somewhere else, but worship God right where you are. And while you worshiping and you communicating with God, at some point, he's going to talk to you and say, go forth, now is the time. But he called this place Bel Perazim, or the Lord of breakthroughs. How many people want the Lord to break through some difficulties in your life? This is it. Let's look at the next slide. We have to start developing a dependence on God. Not just believing in God, but depending on God. God, if you don't help me, I can't be helped. God, only your way is the best way. God, I'm depending on you to come through. We have to develop that dependence on of God, and we got to develop it to where we're starting to walk like that and live like that. And if we start to walk like that and live like that, God can go before us and start breaking up some things. God can start elevating us. He can start making a way where it seemed to be no way. Let's look at the next couple of slides. And the next slide, it says, these are a couple of steps. Now, they are simple, but if practiced, they can help us to gain breakthrough. Pray. This is one of my favorite scriptures, Luke 18:1. It says, in difficult times, don't faint, but pray. How many people had some difficult times in your life? And I had some difficult times where I didn't even know what to do, but the only thing I could do is follow the scripture and pray. And at least I can obey that, and I release the results to who? To God. And not sitting there worried about something I can't change anyway. I'm going to pray about it. I'm going to release this thing to God. Praise God. And I've seen God do some things. Praise God. And change some things. Praise God. And break through some things. The next one is study to show yourself approved. So study to see what God is saying in his word. And you hold on to what God says you in his word, come hell or high water, praise God, when everything is coming against you, you remember the word of God in your life. Praise God, saying that I shall live. You sick and your body hurting, but you remember, I will live and not die, and I will proclaim the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You keep praying and feeding yourself that, praise God. Jesus was wounded for my transgressions. He was bruised for my iniquities. The chastisement that brings me wholeness and peace was upon him. And by his stripes, I'm already healed. And you keep saying it. You keep holding on to what God says and to what God says. But see what I'm saying? And you get it in your mind. Remember we said you got to get this in your mind and in your spirit. And you keep it there when your body hurt, when you don't feel like, when your leg won't move. You keep saying what God says and keep trying to move your leg just a little bit. And then practice. Study and then practice. And when you practice and when you do what God tells you to do, sometimes it's going to put you in a situation where it don't seem like, why in the world am I even trying? Why in the world, based on everything that has happened before, based on all the other times that I've tried, why in the world should I even try anymore? But you pray and you continue to step forth and you continue to walk believing that God is going to go before you as he's led you, and believing that just like he made a way for the children of Israel, like we talked about last week through that Red Sea, he's going to make a way for you. If he did it before, he can do it again. The same God right now is the same God back then. He is the same God. He's just looking for people to trust him and believe him as you stand. The first step begins with us putting our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, admitting that we are sinners. The Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There's none righteous, no, not one. But the Bible also says that God so loved the world that he gave his only, his best begotten son, Jesus Christ, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but shall have everlasting life. And so now he wants us to admit our sins, believe that he sent Jesus for our sins to die and to be raised again for our justification, and then accept the gift of salvation by coming forth and believing in our hearts and confessing with our mouths. And at that time, we will be saved. So is there somebody today, he's already made a way to break us out of eternal damnation and hell, which everybody deserves, and make a way for us to be with him forever in glory? Is there somebody that wants to come and give your life to Jesus today? We'll say a prayer, and you'll pretty much just receive what God has already given to you. Is there somebody that wants to come and pray today? You can come and receive what Jesus has already done for you. Maybe there's somebody who has been visiting this church for a while, you've been visiting this church for a while, but today you want to make this church your church home. You can come. Is there somebody that wants to come and join this local church? You can come. Maybe there's somebody who heard this word and it resonates with your heart, with your situation, with your circumstance, and you want to look to God to do a new thing in your life, to help you move forward into who he's purposed and planned for you to be. If this message has resonated with you in any form, any shape, any fashion, and you want to step forth in faith and ask God to work this word in your life, and you believe in God and you trust in God and you stepping forth based on what God has said as he's spoken, so you come forth in faith. Pastor Wolf, we have Pastor Wolf as our youth pastor. We have some young people, as Pastor Wolf called them, that's coming to for baptism. So this is Pastor Wolf, this is our youth pastor. And now, baptism is a step that we do on the outside for something that's happening on the inside. So we want to make sure that you already received Jesus Christ as your Savior and your Lord. And it's very simple. It's God's gift to you. And it's God's gift to you. It's salvation. Amen. And so this is all you have to do. If you can put your hands here,
we're going to just say a prayer. And it's simply just admitting that we don't do everything right. That's called sin. When we mess up and we thought we wanted to do something, but we didn't do it, we did what we know is wrong sometimes. That's called sin. But God still loves us all. He loves you, ladies. And he showed that love by giving Jesus to live a holy life. He never done anything wrong, but yet he died for your sins and my sins. And so now the only thing you're doing is admitting that you're a sinner and receiving the gift of Jesus Christ, praise God, in your heart and saying it out with your mouth. And at that point, you will be daughters of God. Then we'll take the next steps of baptism, okay? Let's pray.
God, I admit that
I'm a sinner.
That I'm a sinner.
But I thank you.
But I thank you.
That you still love me.
That you still love me.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For living a holy life.
For living a holy life.
And not doing anything wrong.
And not doing anything wrong.
But yet.
Dying.
For all my wrong.
For all my wrong.
And all my sins.
And all my sins.
Jesus.
I accept you.
As my Savior.
As my Savior.
And my Lord. Come into my life. Give me your Holy Spirit. That you promised those. Who believe.
I thank you.
That I'm a child of God. I'm saved. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Well, God bless you, ladies. You all are going to go back with our ministry leaders. They're going to share some more with you about the Lord and about this ministry. So give us your name.
Elora Xavier.
She's coming to join this local assembly. So she already has given her life to the Lord, but she's coming here just to join the local assembly, and we want to give you the right hand of fellowship and welcome. And as Pastor Jones always says, you're a part of this local assembly that was missing before, but we thank God that you're here, and we welcome you to learn and to grow and to use the gifts that God has placed within you to help us to go forth. Amen. God bless you and God keep you. You have anything to say? Anything to say?
I came to this church before with my granddaughter Jahili, and from the time I came here, I loved this church. My church in Miami was Mount Sinai Mission Baptist Church, but since I came here, I fall in love with this church, just like my church in Miami, and I want to be a member. I love Pastor Jones and everybody else. Amen.
Amen. Welcome. God bless you. Can go back to Sister Claire. Is there anything else? All right. And what's your name?
Sheila Lockhart.
Well, we welcome you back. We want to give you the right hand of welcome and fellowship. Praise God. And we thank you for coming. And you know we're always here for you. And we're going to ask you to go back with our ministry leaders there. And they're going to share some information just so you can get caught up and learn some things that's going on in the church. Do you have anything else that you want to share? Nothing? All right. Well, welcome. God bless you. Amen. So those of us that are here now, we're just depending on God, and we're looking to God for whatever situations that we have in our life, knowing that God has a purpose and knowing that God has a plan, and asking God to go before us in these situations and things that's happening in our life, and asking him to show us the way and open up a way where it seems to be no way. So let's look to the Lord. God, we thank you, Lord, and we worship you on today. We give you honor, God. We give you glory, and we give you praise. I thank you, God, for this word, God, that you have sent forth on today. And you sent it forth, God, for the edification of your people, Lord God, and for the building up of your kingdom.
And you knew, God, who needed it. You knew, God, the hearts who would receive it. And you know those who are holding on to it and expecting you, God, to break through and shake things up, Lord, in their life, God, and to do, God, what only you can do, God, to make a way, God, where it seems to be no way, God. And even as they stand before us, God, we're standing here because of your word and because of what you shared. And Lord, we're asking you to perform the word, God, in which you've caused your servants, Lord, and your people to hope, God. We thank you, God, that as we come forth this morning, God, that you're watching over your word, God, to perform it. That you're watching over your word in each and every one of these situations, God, and you're going to perform, God, and you're going to bring forth fruit, Lord God, and you're going to bring forth manifestation, and you're going to bring forth, God, breakthrough, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, God. So we receive it, we expect it, Lord, we believe it, and it is done, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you and give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you and keep you as I pray.